What's up, everybody? I wanted to take a minute before the video started to talk about what's going on in our world today. The injustices that Black Americans face on a daily basis in our country is honestly despicable. And I want to encourage every single one of you to support the Black Lives Matter movement in any way that you can, whether that's going out to protests or donating or just any way that you can help, signing those petitions, however you can help, please do so. I'm gonna link some resources down below in the description so that you all can help with that as well. And this is also for my non-Black friends, obviously, that goes without saying. So just educate yourself, educate those in your life. If you see people acting out and acting against what the Black Lives Matter movement stands for, then please step in and say something. Use your white privilege for good. Also, just make sure, like I said, that you donate if you can, that you come out to the protests if you can. Johnny and I just went to one last night. We're planning on going to more soon. Please just show up and show out and let the world know that the way that Black Americans have been treated for numerous years stops now. Like, there's going to be no more of it. So please also stay safe. I would hate if anything happened to anyone else, and I honestly just want you all to stay safe. And also remember that silence is violence. Also, I'm going to be posting this intro on all of my videos until further notice. Thank you all for watching my video. Thank you all for supporting the Black Lives Matter movement. And without further ado, let's hop on into this week's video. What's up, everybody? My name is Brandon and welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be doing my book haul for like the past few months. As you all know, COVID-19 or coronavirus was rampant and still is rampant. So like a lot of bookstores have been closed and I was devastated. But now that they're open, I kind of went a little buck wild and got probably too many books, but you know, it's fine. I just consider it making up for lost time and supporting authors during this hard time as well. So yeah, that's what I tell myself. Without further ado, let's hop on into the books that I've accumulated over the past few months. The first book that I got was from my local bookstore. I did curbside pickup from Scuppernog's Books, and this was a pre-order, and it is The Ballad of Songbirds and Snakes by Suzanne Collins. Obviously, everyone and their mom knows that this is the prequel book to the Hunger Games series. If you've been on my channel for a hot minute, you know that I recently reread the Hunger Games trilogy in anticipation of this book, and now I'm scared because obviously I loved those books, and revisiting them honestly reignited that love that I had for that series. And this one, everyone is saying, is not good. Like, I see so many negative reviews. I haven't seen a completely positive review of this book. So I'm nervous. I'm scared to read it because I'm scared that it's going to taint my ideas on the Hunger Games trilogy and Suzanne Collins as an author of this series. Yeah, one light at the end of the tunnel though, one thing that I'm looking at and hoping that it will drive me to read this book very soon is they say it's a lot more dark and a lot more grotesque in this book than it was in the Hunger Games trilogy, and that intrigues me incredibly. So I'm hoping that that alone will drive me to read this book really soon. But I heard that there are a lot of negative things about it, like the characters and the pacing, and obviously it's 500 pages, so it's like almost 200 pages, if not more, longer than the Hunger Games trilogy books, so I'm just so nervous. So if you've read this book, please let me know down in the comment section below what you thought of it, and maybe if you enjoyed it, it will push me to read it a lot sooner. But obviously, I have to read it someday, but
As of right now, I don't know when that day is. So next we're gonna talk about the books that I got from my local used bookstore, and that is McKay's. The first book that I got is Hearts Invisible Furies by John Boyne, which is an LGBTQ plus book. It talks about a kid who is adopted and kind of faces a lot of challenges growing up in life, and you know, that disconnect from his mother who was also ostracized. But it also is like a coming of age tale where he's coming to terms with who he is, and where he stands in society and in his adopted family, but also who he is sexually and coming into his sexuality. And I've heard incredible things about this book, and I saw it at McKay's for like $4. So I was like, obviously I have to buy it. So I'm really excited to hop on into this one soon. So the next book that I got is another LGBTQ plus book, and that is Smash Cut by Brad Gooch. This is a memoir of Howard and art in the 70s and the 80s. So as it says in the subtitle, this is a memoir of sorts from Brad Gooch talking about his love with Howard and his love for art and his experiences in the 70s and 80s as a gay man and being in a gay relationship. So it's really short. I'm super excited to read it. I know this book is gonna wreck me just from the synopsis that I read about it. It talks a lot about the AIDS epidemic as well. I believe Howard contracts AIDS, and so I know it's gonna wreck me. I know it's gonna be hard to read, but I'm really excited to pick this one up, and I'm hoping that I can get to it before the end of Pride Month, but if not, I know I'll be reading it soon anyway. Another reason I picked up this book was look how cute they are as a couple. Like, are you serious? They're so cute. Like, yes, their apartment is dirty and dingy and kind of gross looking, but together, like, they're just so happy. Like, the smiles on their faces, it just makes me love, and I am just so excited to read this book and see what my thoughts are. The next book that I got is Between the World and Me by Ta-Nehisi Coates, and this book is a sort of letter that Ta-Nehisi is writing to his son, and it's about his life and his experiences in America, mainly with racial injustices that he's faced and that a lot of Black Americans face, and almost preparing his son for the harsh reality of our world and being optimistic and hoping that that changes by the time he is grown. I've heard amazing things about it. I saw it at McKay's for like $6, and obviously I had to pick it up. It's such an acclaimed work, and I cannot wait to hop into it. Plus, it's really short. I've read the first few pages and really loved it, so I am dying to get to this one very, very soon. The next book that I got is one that I've had before, but it was in a cover I didn't like. And then I saw this version at McKay's with the cover that I like for like, I think it was like $3 or $4. And that is In Cold Blood by Truman Capote. Now, this is a true crime novel about someone breaking into the house of a family and killing everyone in that family and in the house. And Truman Capote breaks down what happened as well as the investigation of the murders. And it just sounds like a really, really dark, but incredible story. I am a big fan of Forensic Files, if you guys didn't know. So I love true crime, and I've never read a true crime book, I don't think. Maybe one, but not many. I haven't read many true crime books, so I'm really excited to hop into this one. They say this is like one of the best true crime novels, so I'm really excited to hop into this one and see what my thoughts are. But also, this edition, I didn't know until I got home, was annotated by the person who read it last. So it's got literal like underlines and circles and like annotations, and I am so excited to read this. Now, a lot of people don't like their books pre-annotated. I get it, I really do. But for me, I love the idea of reading an annotated book. So yeah, this book I'm super excited to hop into because of that as well. And I can't wait to write my thoughts alongside this person's thoughts and just like have a conversation with a person that I've never and probably will never meet in my life and just be able to see what their thoughts were in this text. I love that idea, and I'm so excited to hop into this book. Another book that I got from McKay's was a brand new release that I was shocked to see there. Granted, it was like $13-14. I didn't care because like that's still cheaper than buying it at Barnes & Noble. So that book is The Everlasting by Katie Simpson Smith, and this one follows a few different generations of Roman citizens and their experiences in Rome and how Rome is this like romantic place. So I'm really excited to see where this book goes and how these stories interconnect. And mainly, I'm excited to be in the world of Rome, because I've never read a book set in Rome, but I love Rome. Well, I guess I have, like, mythology and stuff, but I really love Rome and I want to visit it someday, and that's like my number one dream vacay spot. So I want to read a bit more about it before going and really be able to appreciate it for what it is when I'm there, and just kind of visit it vicariously through our main characters in this book. So I'm super excited for this. The next book that I got from McKay's is a classic, and I've heard amazing things about it, and that is The Count of Monte Cristo by Alexander Dumas. I am so excited to hop into this book. One, I'm terrified because of how gigantic it is. Like, it's like 600 pages-ish. So it's a honker, and it's classic too, so it's gonna be more difficult to read. But this is an incredible story of revenge and vengeance, and I love a good revenge story. And as you all know, I've read Othello by William Shakespeare so many times, and my favorite character is the villain, Iago, because of the vengeance that he seeks out and the capability that he has to manipulate and to get people back. And he's just such a great villain. And so I'm excited to hop into this one and see what kind of revenge that our main character, Edmund, gets himself into. Don't love this cover, obviously. It's very ugly, but it was like $6 at McKay's, and I don't know if I'm gonna love it yet. So I think it's safe to say, like, buying it for $6, reading it, and if I like it, buying a more beautiful cover, because I'm sure there is one out there. But anyway, I'm so excited to get to this one as well. And the last book that I got from McKay's is another classic and is another Barnes & Noble exclusive edition. I got this one for also $6. And if you thought The Count of Monte Cristo was big, wait till you see Don Quixote by Miguel de Cervantes. And boy, this is huge. Like, how many pages is it? It's, oh my god, it's like 900 pages. So, don't know if I'm gonna get to this one very soon, but I do want to get to this. I have seen so many videos recently where people talk about how they were scared to read this book because it's so big and bulky and they were nervous, and then they ended up reading it and it becomes their favorite novel of all time. And like, that's been the story for so many people's videos that I've seen. So I'm really excited to see what I think of it. And I would love to have a new favorite novel, and especially if it's a classic. So I want to hop into this one very soon as well. But this one is kind of like the first adventure story, it sounds like. And there is just like a lot of comedy and a lot of adventure, like I said, and action and stuff. So it sounds really interesting, and I want to get to this one pretty soon too. Girl, I am going to be so scared away from it for a while, because 900 pages is a lot. So we'll see when I get to it. All right, so next I went shopping at Barnes & Noble, which I hardly ever do because, girl, should be overpriced, okay? Like, overpriced. And it's already this big company, and I prefer to give my money to local bookstores or Amazon for convenience sake. But yeah, Barnes & Noble I hardly shop at, but I went the other day and there were so many books there and I just wanted them at that moment. And so I bought them. And the first book that I bought was Homegoing by Ya Gyasi. And this book just sounds so incredible. It follows two half-sisters, one who marries an Englishman and one who becomes enslaved in the same castle that the woman who married the Englishman lives in. And it just follows their parallel paths through 8 generations. So their descendants as well. And it just goes to show you like how trauma is sort of passed down, and how, you know, these ideals and these hardships are passed down through generations, and it is a sad thing. And I'm really excited to read this. It's pretty short, so the fact that it goes through 8 generations of these family members really intrigues me, because we're gonna have obviously 8 main characters in this short book. So I'm hoping that it'll be a quick read, and I've heard nothing but amazing things about this book, so I'm hoping to get to this one very soon. The next book we have is The Nickel Boys by Colson Whitehead. Now, this book talks about like the civil rights era and Jim Crow laws, and our main character is trying to follow Martin Luther's dreams. Vision, and he gets himself into some trouble, makes a mistake, and gets sent to like this institution for boys to be made into better men. It turns out when he gets there that the other boys there are being abused physically and I believe sexually as well. And he just wants to break out, and there's another guy that he meets there. They both become friends, but his friend ends up being like a cynic, and he's like, no, Martin Luther King Jr. has it wrong. Like, there's no way it's gonna change. So yeah, I'm just really excited to read this book. It's, again, very short, and yeah, I'm hoping to get this one very soon as well. I know I keep saying that for all of them, but I really do mean it. I really want to get to this one up very soon. The next book that I got from Barnes & Noble was The Water Dancer by Ta-Nehisi Coates. This is the same author as Between the World and Me that I talked about earlier. And first of all, can we talk about how stunning this cover is? Like, it's so beautiful, and the back is beautiful as well. But this, I believe, is like a magical realism story about slavery and the effects that it has on Black Americans, obviously, and Black American men specifically in this book. So I'm really excited to get to this one. I've heard amazing things about this one as well, and God, I just can't stop looking at the cover. Like, it's so stunning. So I'm excited to get to this one. The last book that I got from Barnes & Noble was The Vanishing Half by Britt Bennett. Now, the reason I'm holding it like this is because Barnes & Noble decided to put a sticker on it, and it's one of those velvety covers, so the sticker will not come off. And I've tried everything that I know to do, so if you have any suggestions for how to get this sticky stuff off this velvety book, please leave them down below in the comment section, because I would love to be able to do that, because I hate this so much. But moving on, The Vanishing Half by Britt Bennett is about two Black twin sisters, and one of them is white passing, and it talks about the experiences that they had in their lives and how different their lives are because of this colorism within their own community, and the lives of these sisters, though they separate for a bit, they end up coming back together, and their descendants as well end up meeting and having experiences. And it sounds really interesting and really intriguing to me. And I've heard amazing things. Like, this is blowing up on BookTube right now, so I cannot wait to get to this one soon either. Like I said, I know I keep saying it, but this one, I mean, like, this one, it sounds so good. In the last 12 books, yes, you heard me right, 12 more, I got from Amazon. And the first one that I got was Why I'm No Longer Talking to White People About Race by Renee Edo Lodge. I've heard amazing things about this one, and I've seen it a lot recently on BookTube because of the Black Lives Matter movement that's going on. And they say that this is a quintessential piece for white people to read. And so I'm really interested to see what this book covers. I don't know much about like the specifics of what it covers, but I do obviously know it talks about race and how white people can be better allies to the Black community. So that's all I really need to know. I'm super excited to get into this book, and it's not really that long, and the margins are kind of big, and it's like double space, so I know that I'll be able to fly through this one once I get it. But yes, I plan on getting to this one sooner than some of the other ones because I'm so interested. Next, along the same lines as that last book, we have White Rage by Carol Anderson, and this book talks specifically about how like our history is told from the point of view of white people, because they were the victors of these historical events. And so the white people were able to craft this idea of what history was, and it's not really what it was. And so in White Rage, Carol Anderson goes into detail about the real events that happened in history and how, you know, it was altered and why it was altered. And I am so excited to get into this one and to open my eyes to, you know, the truth of history. So I'm really looking forward to reading this and finding out more about the real history of the United States. The next book that I have is So You've Been Publicly Shamed by John Ronson. And specifically now I wanted to read this because cancel culture is bigger now than it ever was, in my opinion. And, you know, the past few years, cancel culture has been really big. I'm not the biggest fan of cancel culture altogether. And so I really wanted to read this book and find out more about, one, why it started and where it came from, and to better understand like the preceding events as well as the psychological effects that it can have to be canceled or publicly shamed. And I think that this is an interesting book to get into right now, especially like I said before, but I'm just really excited to hop on into this and to learn more about something that I don't really know that much about, but that is pretty prevalent in our world today. So yes, I'm excited for this one. The next book that I have is one that you've all seen in a video unboxing on my, I think it was my April wrap up, and that is On Earth We're Briefly Gorgeous by Ocean Vuong. I read this book last month and thoroughly enjoyed it. I thought it was so beautifully done. But if you want more of my thoughts, you can check out my May wrap up. But yes, I really enjoyed this book, and it's about Ocean Vuong's experience in America and being the descendant of immigrants and being a minority and being queer and just really talking about the hardships that he faced through life because of his identities. And it was really beautifully done, and he's a poet, so if you like flowery writing, I think you'll like this book as well. So definitely give it a read if you are interested. The next book that I have is The Deviant Spore: The Homosexual versus the United States of America by Eric Cervini. I started following Eric Cervini on Instagram a few months ago because he was doing like book clubs and stuff for LGBTQ plus books. That's where I read and heard about On Earth We're Briefly Gorgeous, and he released his own book. It's so big, but I am really excited to get into this one. It chronicles the life of Frank Kameny, who was a really big advocate for LGBTQ plus rights. And I just want to know more about Frank Kameny. For those of you who have been watching my Stonewall reading vlogs, Frank Kameny was, I think, in my first reading vlog, or maybe the second one. And I talk about how much I disliked what he had to say. He compared a lot of the experiences of homosexual people to the experiences of Black Americans during the Civil Rights era. And yes, while I get that there are some connections and some similarities, Frank took it a step further by saying that queer people had it worse. And I'm like, no. But okay, so yeah, I'm interested to see what Eric Cervini has to chronicle of Frank's life in here, and maybe I can gain a better understanding of Frank and a better understanding of where he was coming from. And hopefully, I didn't have the context for what he was saying, and that's why I didn't understand it. I don't know, but we'll see. So I'm really looking forward to this one. And again, Eric Cervini, because I pre-ordered this book, is sending like bookmarks and pins and a book plate to me. So I'm excited to get those as well. I haven't gotten them yet, but so excited. The next book that I got was My Dark Vanessa by Kate Elizabeth Russell. I've heard nothing but amazing things about this book. And it is a story of a young girl who was in a relationship with her high school English teacher. She was 15, he was 42. And now she's like, let's see, 15 plus 17 would be, oh shit, like 32. And now she's 32, and some allegations are being thrown about in regard to the teacher that she had as her first love. And at the start of the novel, she said to defend him and fully believe that their relationship was consensual. But as the book moves on, she starts to realize how manipulative he was and how wrong he was in starting a relationship with her, and her ideology starts to change, and she has to face a lot of hard stuff in herself. And this just sounds like a really, really interesting and dark novel, and I'm just really excited to read it. The next book that we have is The Fifth Season by N.K. Jemisin, who is an author that I've heard a lot about on BookTube recently. A lot of people are saying that she's such a fantastic fantasy author, and this is a lot of people's favorite book by her, and it chronicles this fantasy world where the world keeps ending every so often, and people are starting to believe that there are people behind these natural disasters that are occurring to end the world, and that's just what it sounds like. Other than that, I don't know much about this book, but I am really excited to hop on into it, and I've been wanting to read some more fantasy recently, so this is one that is definitely on my radar to get to very soon. The next two books that I have are from the same author, and that is Freshwater and Pet by Akwaeke Emezi. And Freshwater is about a Nigerian girl who is born with a bunch of different gods in her, and she goes to college in America and faces a traumatic experience, and because of that, these gods sort of crystallize. And from my understanding, it's about Ada coming to terms with who she is and possibly even her gender identity and things like that, which is incredible, and I'm so excited to read from it, especially because this is a own voices author. Akwaeke Emezi is trans and non-binary, and so it's really interesting to experience the ideologies of gender and gender construction and our societal understanding of what gender is in like a magical realism way. And I'm just really excited to see how it's done and what's talked about. And like I said, the fact that it's own voices is really intriguing to me because we really get a deeper understanding of, you know, gender in the headspace of someone who is trans and non-binary. So I'm so excited for this one. And Pet by Akwaeke Emezi, I've already started. I'm about 30 pages in and loving it. Pet is about a trans girl named Jam living in a world where angels rule. There used to be monsters that ruled, and they were bigoted and hateful, and there was a lot of bad done, but the angels came in and kind of took out the monsters, and now everyone believes that there are no more monsters left in the world. However, our main character Jam meets one of these monsters, and I don't know much else of what's going on because, like I said, I'm only 30 pages in, but that's what's happened so far, and I'm really excited for where this book is going. I think that the commentary that Akwaeke Emezi is able to capture in this tale is incredible, and there's so many things that I'm marking up, and it's just so relevant today as well. So yeah, I'm really excited to continue on with this one very, very soon. And again, it's so short, like it's only like 200 pages, so it should be a really fast read. The next book that we have is Girl, Woman, Other by Bernadine Evaristo. And this just seems to chronicle best the lives of British Black women. And it talks about like a lesbian playwright, and then there is a jaded school teacher, and then a non-binary social media influencer, and a bunch of other characters that I'm really interested to read about, and how their lives connect over different generations. Yeah, I've heard amazing things, and I'm really excited to get to this one very soon. The next book that I have is Felix Ever After by Kaysen Callender. And this is about a trans boy in high school who faces a bully who is releasing pictures of him pre-transition, and using his dead name and things like that. And throughout this experience, trying to find out who this bully is and put a stop to it, he has a love triangle, and he's trying to determine who he loves and what he loves and who he is as a person, and just diving deeper into his identity. And I think that this is going to be an amazing book. And it reminds me from the synopsis a lot of Simon versus the Homo Sapiens Agenda. And I cannot wait to get to this one and see what my thoughts are, because yes, it's going to be great. And last but certainly not least, we have All Boys Aren't Blue by George M. Johnson. Now, this is another memoir. It's like a YA memoir, which you hardly ever see. But it chronicles George M. Johnson's experiences in his life with being Black and being queer and assault and racism and so many harsh topics. And I've read the introduction so far, and I think that it is so beautifully done. And one thing that I want to share with you all is, it says, this book will touch on sexual assault, including molestation, loss of virginity, homophobia, racism, and anti-Blackness. These discussions at times may be a bit graphic, but nonetheless, they are experiences that many reading this book will encounter or have already encountered. And I want those readers to be seen and heard in these pages. And I think that this is just such an important work, and I cannot wait to hop into it very soon. Like I said, I've read a little bit of it, and I'm loving it so far. So, like, I just need to get through all of these books right now, because I'm so excited about it. It sounds so good. And can we talk about this cover? Like, stunning. And in the back, it's like, be bold, be brave, and queer. I just love it. It's just so cute to me, and I cannot wait to see what I think of the inside as well. Like I said, I've heard amazing things, so I'm really looking forward to getting into this one. And before I sign off with you all on this video, I did want to share which books that I bought are by Black authors and about Black characters. And if you're looking for books to support the Black Lives Matter movement and support Black creators and Black voices, these are the ones that you need to check out. So it was Between the World and Me, The Vanishing Half, The Water Dancer, The Nickel Boys, Homegoing, White Rage and Why I'm No Longer Talking to White People About Race, The Fifth Season, Freshwater and Pet, Girl, Woman, Other, Felix Ever After, and All Boys Aren't Blue. So all 13 of these books are, like I said, from Black authors and about Black characters. And please, please support Black creators and Black voices by checking some of these out. If you have any other, oh shit. If you have any other suggestions for me for books by Black authors and about Black characters, please, please let me know, because I would love to check them out. These were just some that I had on my radar already and that I've been wanting to get for a while and just finally went out and bought. So please, if you have any others, let me know and I would be glad to read them. I'm hoping to get to these very, very soon. And if you've read any of these and have any thoughts, please leave them in the comment section below and I would love to hear what you thought of it. All right, everybody, that does it for this video. If you liked it, please give it a big thumbs up. Make sure you subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. And also hit that post notification bell so you are notified every time that I post a new video. My name is Brandon and I will see you all next time. Bye.